Now, according to the schedule, we have the next talk without interruption. Александр Львович, без перерыва будем? Вас, да? So, the next lecture is by Alexander Fradkov. It's on the legacy of Vladimir Yakubovich.
Dear colleagues, actually, it is a big honor for me to present a talk for such a topic. And at the same time, we had no other choice. This conference is dedicated to the memory of Professor Yakubovich, my teacher, and I felt responsibility to make a talk like that. So I'll try to do my best because I first time met Vladimir Andreevich Yakubovich when I was very, very young, maybe 50 years ago. And I was happy to communicate with him for these 50 years, so there are some documents and memories, and I would like to share with you some ideas and feelings of what we learned from Vladimir Andreevich Yakubovich. So, what legacy comes from Professor Yakubovich? Actually, we in St. Petersburg are lucky because Yakubovich was born in Novosibirsk, which is far in Siberia. He studied in Moscow, in Moscow State University, and then he came to St. Petersburg, to Leningrad that time. And finally, he established here a great how to say, a group which was growing and had a lot of connection with other groups. And so we say that this is a school, scientific school, created and headed by Yakubovich. And because he studied in Moscow, he had brought a lot of ideas from Moscow mathematicians. When he was a student at Moscow State University, his teachers were Professor Kolmogorov, Professor Gelfand, Professor Nemitsky, who were great mathematicians of that time. And he learned from them and brought his knowledge to St. Petersburg, actually. His biography was not very smooth. After studying in Moscow, he was not able to stay there. He was suggested to move to St. Petersburg. He was an engineer in industry for 3 years. Then he was teacher in some technical university, mining university at Leningrad. And finally, he came to St. Petersburg State University. That time, Leningrad University, it was a big success for this university where we are now all remembering him. And till the end of his life, he was head of the theoretical cybernetics department, which was founded by him. How can we evaluate the scientific school created by Vladimir Yakubovich? He and his former students, members of the school, produced more than 40 candidates of sciences, PhD in Russian, more than 10 doctors of science, corresponding member of Russian Academy of Science, IEEE fellow and two IEEE senior members, published more than 60 books and 15 books, now maybe even more, published internationally. In 1993, Yakubovich got Nobel winner international prize for his contribution to cybernetics. And finally, in 1996, Yakubovich was awarded with a very important award, annual IEEE Control System Award, and the medal with the citation for pioneer and fundamental contribution to stability analysis and optimal control. And this is indeed a very important award. There are only 34 persons all over the world who possess this award. Only two persons from Russia, Yakubovich and academician Krasovsky, Nikolai Nikolaevich Krasovsky. And I'm happy that here at this conference we can see four awardees of this great award. It's my pleasure to mention their names: Professor Carl Ostrom, Professor Roger Brockett, Professor Graham Goodwin, and Professor Alberto Isidori. Let us applaud to them, because it's great achievement. So the level of this conference is very high. How can we classify the legacy of Vladimir Yakubovich? Actually, books, what is most important contribution of a person to science? And Yakubovich was co-author of 9 books. Here we can see 8 of them. One book, translation of his book with Starzynski on linear differential equations, has 2 parts. That's why we say 9 books. And all these achievements contained in this book can be split into several areas, more or less in chronological order. The early works of Yakubovich were dedicated to linear periodic Hamiltonian systems. It's works of 50s. He started even when he was a student of Moscow University. And next area is nonlinear system stability and oscillations, starting from 60s. Probably is the most well-known and the most valuable contribution to control theory by him and his school. Next one is adaptive systems, then optimal control, and finally late works of Yakubovich. And I would like to expose separately all these fields. First, early works, linear periodic Hamiltonian systems. He extended, actually, when he was still student of last year in Moscow University, he extended the results of Ljapunov and Zhukovsky for the Hill equations, and proposed a new approach to the theory of oscillation in the linear Hamiltonian systems. And as an application of this theory, new advanced theory of parametric resonance was created. Particularly, he proposed a method enabling identification of all domains of dynamic instability. And the theory was used to analyze the wreck of Tacoma Bridge, which was studied by many people, and his hypothesis was that parametric resonance, multiple parametric resonance, has an active role in this disaster. At this conference, I would like to mention that there will be a plenary talk by Roger Brockett last day, the final talk, which to some extent related to this area. And it's good that we will have this talk. The students of Yakubovich working in parametric resonance were 2 professors. Unfortunately, both of them passed away: Professor Vladimir Nikolaevich Fomin and Professor Ivanovich Dirguzov. And unfortunately, we do not have now their successors in Russia. So nobody is working in this area now. That's why I think it will be very interesting to listen to the talk by Roger related to this area. Now come to stability and oscillations. The book which was published in Russian in 1978 and published in English in year 2004, co-authored by Yakubovich, Leonov and Gelik, for us, for his student, was actually a Bible. Everything important was in this book. And that time we were studying it, we were not able to understand everything. At least I was not able to understand everything because there were many deep ideas. And even now it attracts interest because it was translated into English a quarter of a century after it was published in Russian. It's a remarkable event. What are results achieved in this area? Of course, number one is the method of matrix inequalities. It was published in a series of papers, Automation Remote Control, beginning of 60s. And indeed, the value of these achievements can be estimated from the words written by Stephen Boyd, who said that he invented the technology of linear matrix inequality, and he said that Yakubovich was father of this field and Lyapunov was a grandfather of this field. Then circle criterion, I will be speaking about this later. General criterion of absolute stability, Yakubovich quadratic criterion. I will not be speak about this. I will speak a little bit about Kalman-Yakubovich Popov Lemma, which we called among us a frequency theorem, because Professor Yakubovich was too modest to call it like that. He said frequency theorem. Okay. But between us, we call it Yakubovich Kalman Lemma, as Professor Kalman suggested this morning. And S procedure is a very exciting area. And finally, oscillatory, Yakubovich oscillatory of differential equations. And I will not speak about details because there will be a talk. You know, there will be a series of special invited sessions dedicated to areas of Yakubovich and his school. And the first talk in each session will be a survey talk, 40 minutes. And Professor Nikita Barabanov will be giving such a talk tomorrow at 11:30. So I invite everyone to this talk. We'll be speaking about absolute stability and related things. So, what we should say about Kalman-Yakubovich lemma? I would like to quote what was written in the paper by Vladimir Razvan for a special issue of a journal of robust nonlinear control dedicated to 80th anniversary of Yakubovich. The turning point of the 60s in the 20th century from the point of view of qualitative behavior of dynamical systems was the discovery of Yakubovich Kalman-Popov lemma, or as called sometimes, the great lemma of system theory. If we speak priority, the first paper was published by Yakubovich in 1962. The next paper was due to Rudolf Kalman in 1963, and paper of Popov deals with multivariable version, several control functions, published in 1964. So great years, heroic years of control theory, 60s. You can find something about Kalman-Yakubovich-Popov Lemma in Wikipedia. At least these equations are more or less true. And actually, these equations for which frequency domain conditions of existence of solvability were the issue of the lemma were discovered before 60s by a Russian mathematician and expert in mechanics, Lurie, Anatoly Isakovich Lurie. His first book, first ever book in nonlinear control, was published in 1951. I have a book with me, by the way. And equations, he called them resolution equation. In St. Petersburg, in Leningrad, we call them Lurie equations. And Yakubovich showed that these equations, solvability of this equation are equivalent, solvability is equivalent to the frequency domain inequality, which came for special cases from Popov conditions. And now these equations are commonly called algebraic Riccati equations. If we substitute the second one into the first one, we'll obtain quadratic equations for the positive definite matrix P. So algebraic Riccati equation, but we consider, and Yakubovich always told us that fair citation should be Lurie equation, or as a compromise, Lurie-Riccati equations, or Riccati-Lurie equations. Unfortunately, this book of Lurie was not translated into English. So there are different formulations of this lemma. This one is from the classical textbook of Khalil. And here at MICNON, we'll have a talk, I think very interesting talk, by Sergei Gusev, relating this lemma to Hilbert's 17th problem. And I invite everyone, it will be tomorrow at 9 o'clock in Euler room in neighbor university, not here. So, circle criterion. This is well-known criteria for absolute stability, for stability of all the for solutions of the system with the right-hand side split into linear part and non-linear part. Now we often call Lurie system this class of system, and for non-linearity satisfying sector conditions, sector bounded learning non-linearities, this frequency domain condition gives sufficient condition for stability, for absolute stability. And it's interesting, when it was published first, I studied the literature and communicated with Professor Rosenwasser, who gave me some paper, early papers. And in the books, in the different books published both in Russia and in the world, they say that this criterion was obtained independently by a number of the authors. And that's true, but who was the first? So among all these authors. It appeared that there were three papers published in 1963. And I was interested which one was the first. It happened that two papers by Yakubovich and by Rosenwasser were published in March 1963. in two different Russian journals, but both were translated into English. March 1963, and the paper by Buongiorno was published 1 month later, in April. And comparing these two papers by Yakubovich and Rosenwasser, one can find that paper by Rosenwasser was submitted earlier in July, while paper by Yakubovich was submitted in September. So I think fair citation in this case should be the Rosenwasser-Yakubovich-Buongiorno circle criterion. Okay. When you study literature, you may find Yakubovich's name in different places. And such databases like Web of Science or Scopus are very good for this investigation. When you put name Yakubovich and ask where in titles of the paper you can find this name, you may find interesting papers. For example, these same equations as Lurier equations or Riccati equations were called Kalman-Yakubovich equations by Bob Bittmitt in 1981. And following Bittmitt, probably some other authors studied these linear equations, which related to Sylvester equation but different, and called them Yakubovich matrix equation. So I don't know if it is good name or bad name, but nevertheless, good to know that name of Yakubovich is even here for this class of equations. So let's go to adaptive systems. In '60s, when I was a student, undergraduate student, the department of Yakubovich, the people who worked there, were split into two groups: nonlinear people and adaptive people. And I belonged to adaptive group. And more or less, these groups were separated. So it looked like two different areas. And only Yakubovich was a person who understood everything, both areas. And there was published a book, courses by Fomin, Yakubovich, and myself, Adaptive Control Dynamical Systems. Unfortunately, it also was not translated into in English. It was never translated into English. And I should say that the main, in my view, the main contribution of Yakubovich in this area is the method of recursive, finitely convergent algorithm for solving adaptive control problems. Actually, it's the recursive algorithm produced by Yakubovich's method look a little bit like gradient methods, but they have a dead zone. And this dead zone makes very important thing. It allows to partially open the closed loop and allow to solve control and identification problems in the closed loop, which are difficult problems. And by means of this idea, replacing initial goal by solving some infinite system of inequalities, you can transform the initial problem into some tractable one. So this work, this method, this approach was exposed in a couple of papers, particularly the last one is a paper by Bandarka and Yakubovich, which is published in IFAC papers online in year 2007. But I think that this results, this contribution is still underestimated by the community. The potential of this approach is still not exploited, really. In addition to this main contribution in this area, I should mention mathematical definition of adaptive system. Probably the first mathematical definition of adaptive system was proposed by Yakubovich in 1968. Also adaptive robot, the very term adaptive robot was not it was not able to found it to find it in the scientific literature. Of course, the term robot was it came from fiction, but in scientific literature was not used probably until Yakubovich introduced it in the paper, in his paper published in Doklady of Akademia Nauk of Soviet Academy of Sciences. And he was recognized by everyone in St. Petersburg as a leader of the school on adaptive control. Especially due to a number of Leningrad symposia on adaptive system theory, organized several times in St. Petersburg, in that time in Leningrad. And one of them, which happened in 1991, was the first really international, several international guests, where there Sergio Bitanti, Aristide Halanai, Leonard Jung, and Vladimir Razvan, and it was beginning of our cooperation person to person with our foreign partners, friends, and colleagues. Start of new era. And at this conference at MICNON, I would like to mention two talks dedicated to this method, to adaptive control, by Professor Viktor Sokolov and Professor Vladimir Bandarka. It will be on Thursday in the afternoon. Optimal control. This area attracted interest of Yakubovich a little bit later, in the 70s. And probably the leader of and successor of Yakubovich in this area is Professor Alexei Matveev. And I will not speak about this area because much more experienced colleague is here. And I invite everyone to the lecture tomorrow at 3 p.m. by Professor Matveev, dedicated to optimal control in the works of Yakubovich. Also, there were two books published in Russian, and nothing was translated into English, unfortunately. What about late works? In the 90s, the feature of works of research made by Yakubovich and his students was in a combination of the approaches proposed previously. I would like to quote the introduction to one of his papers, which he himself considered as important paper, about non-oscillation of linear periodic Hamiltonian equation and related problems. Words of Yakubovich himself. Main goal of this paper is study of non-oscillatory of linear periodic Hamiltonian equations. Derivation of sufficient conditions is heavily relied upon some ideas and results of Mark Crane in the area of complex analysis. As implication, the positivity condition for the spectrum of periodic self-adjoint differential operator, some results on linear quadratic periodic optimal control problem, and the absolute stability criteria for nonlinear system with periodically time-varying linear part will be established. And look, this inherent unity of the above-mentioned themes Thus, inherent unity of the above-mentioned themes from different areas of mathematics will be demonstrated. Indeed, in this work and consequent works, Yakubovich applied the ideas from his earliest work of 50s to extending frequency theorem, his lemma, to time-varying system, to periodic system, and even to non-periodic system. And it is very interesting because indeed it combines ideas from different areas of mathematics. Another area of late research of Yakubovich was so-called universal regulators. In the early 90s, he initiated a series of work of optimal disturbance attenuation and optimal tracking for oscillatory signals. He has developed this concept of universal regulator, providing optimality under unknown disturbances and reference signals with invariance of output for different external disturbances. And finally, after some years, these results make a final contribution to a dramatic discussion about invariant control systems initiated still in 1939, before World War II, by Shipanov and other people. Discussion were continuing for several decades, and some people accept this idea of invariance. Some people were against it, completely against it, and even Shipanov had some troubles with his career due to this discussion. So, final contribution was made by Yakubovich and his former student Anton Praskurnikov. He is here. And in 1995, Yakubovich was awarded with a prize for the best publication of the year by international publisher Nauka in Russia for his series of works in Universal Controller. And in year 2008, Anton Praskurnikov was awarded with a medal of Russian Academy of Sciences for young researcher. It is also a great achievement of the school of Professor Yakubovich. At this conference, we have two papers related to this area. A paper by Anders Lindqvist, who worked a lot with Yakubovich in the 90s. It will take place today at this room, in this room. And tomorrow at 3:40, Praskurnikov will give another paper, give another talk on this area. So, participants of this conference probably already discovered this picture in their bags. This is a disk prepared for this conference, especially for participants of this conference, by members of the department headed by Yakubovich. And this disk contains complete set of publications of Yakubovich. Of course, most of them are in Russian, but many of them were translated into English, and we tried to collect all of them. We were not successful to collect all of them, because some translation of paper by 60s, from 60s are very difficult to find now. But his students from all over the world helped us, and finally we have more than 100 papers translated into English. All of them are in this disk. Even more, here you can find some books, probably all the books published by Yakubovich, and some publications about him from several special issues of journals and other materials. So I think it's for us it is important to disseminate these ideas of his school, his legacy, and to make it available to experts worldwide. Of course, it is a limited distribution, only for participants of this conference, but participants are free to use it in their work. Okay. This actually the end of my talk as related to the title, to its title, Legacy of Vladimir Yakubovich, scientific part of the talk. But I also have prepared some pictures. Maybe it is interesting for people to look. We have a lot of pictures with Yakubovich during many years of relations. But today maybe I show a few of them. And the last day of the conference, the second historical session, I will have a talk which will be mainly demonstrating the pictures. So those who are interested in more pictures, I invite to my talk on Friday. So let's start with pictures. Sorry, I didn't translate the name, but Tsipkin, some people know. Tsipkin and Yakubovich, two great persons of Soviet science during Soviet times. Sorry for bad quality. Carl Ostrom is here, and Yakubovich. And it was taken in Lund during the first Swedish-Russian control conference. Yakubovich was very happy to participate in these conferences because it was, you know, 1992. It was beginning of new era. It seemed a lot of prospects will be in future, and first time we were able to openly speak with our friends and colleagues in of different nationalities. You know, and I like this picture anyway. So this one is taken in Sydney, in Australia, in 1994. So except Yakubovich, all other persons are here in this room. Nikita Barabanov is over there, and David Hill is also over there. And we organized joint conference workshop on nonlinear adaptive control. We organized it with David Hill, and Yakubovich arrived, and some other people were invited from Russia. It was very nice meeting, I think. Very good reminiscences. Again, in Sydney, at the same conference with in different. Place. You can see here Ivan Marils also. Romeo Ortega is here. And again, Nikita Barabanov. So this is very remarkable picture. 1996, CDC in Kobe, Japan, the place where Yakubovich got his IEEE control system award. And after the ceremony of award, many people were wanting to make a picture with him. I was surprised. I did not expect such an interest. Maybe that time, first time, I recognized how important person in science was my teacher. And here you can see from the left to the right Mike Safanov, Vidya Sagar, George Zames, Yakubovich and Katsuhisa Furuta. And there are some other pictures from this conference. Maybe one of them, Yakubovich with Vadim Utkin. And this one is from lecture at some summer school in the suburbs of St. Petersburg. This school was dedicated to hundred years of Luria birth, and his talk was dedicated to the memory of Luria. Next one is a picture of one of celebration. It was his 75th birthday, 2001, at the department. And Vladimir Andreevich with his wife, Ekaterina Dmitrievna, I hope she's here too. Same day, Professor Leonov and Professor Morozov, leaders of the Faculty of Mathematics and Mechanics. This was during a visit of Steve Boyd in St. Petersburg, year 2004. Yakubovich and Professor Kalman, year 2006, almost 10 years ago. And this is the final one. You know, the last few years he stayed at home and conducted the department from his place. And we organized the seminars, because seminars were an important part of our scientific life. We organized the seminars at his place. We came to his place, had some tea, and discussed scientific problems. And he was very active, and his advices were very useful for us even at that time. So this is a picture from the seminar at his place. Yes, this is the last picture. What should be my final words? Actually, it's a great opportunity for us, for his students, to have such a conference here. Here in the university where he worked for more than half century. You know, the Bible says no prophet is accepted in his own town or country. And maybe this conference will break this tradition and in St. Petersburg, in Russia, in this university, more people will know how great is this great scientist. And also, it is important because in the conference we'll have more than 20 papers related to his work, papers from the special sessions. These papers belong not only to his former students, but also to other people who are interested in works of Yakubovich, who use this, his results, who are in a sense successors of his legacy. And I think the publications which will be produced after this conference and all the information which we'll exchange during the conference is very important to future development of control systems, both in Russia and worldwide. Thank you very much.
Any questions or comments or something to add to this nice presentation?
May I?
Please, yes. You are?
I know my name is Romeo Ortega.
Romeo Ortega,
yeah,
yes.
I was in one of the pictures.
Yes, sure.
I know you're very careful with the sites, and you were very careful to track all the publications of Yakubovich. But I think you forgot one, which is very, very important, which is in the conference, in the IFAC World Conference in Paris in 1972. And to my understanding, that was the first proof of global convergence of an adaptive system. So much before the famous 1980 papers and so on. And actually, just an anecdote, I asked my colleagues from MITMO, the young colleagues, when they study adaptive control, to whom do they credit the first proof of global convergence? And their answer is, we don't know. It's Gooding, Ramach and Keynes, Morse and so on. To my knowledge, it was Yakubovich, the first proof. And I think it's something that very few people know. But that was it.
Thank you for recalling this paper. Indeed, the IFAC Congress in Paris, 1972, was a place where first time the ideas of this recurrent goal inequalities was the ideas were exposed to the community. And Yakubovich visited Paris, and in Leningrad, in his department, tell you a story. An example which Yakubovich used in this paper to illustrate his ideas was control of a bicycle. How to amend a human when started ride the bicycle when you cannot. Control in the beginning. After some time of learning or adaptation, you are able to control it. So the challenge was for Yakubovich to create a robot, an algorithm, which could control the bicycle, unstable plant. And he succeeded in it, and he showed this example. This paper was accepted for the IFAC Congress, he visited Paris, and that's why we were saying Yakubovich reached Paris by bicycle.
Any more comments or questions? No, thank you very much.
Thank you.